Are going to give you a list of roads in the capital region which remain impassable due to flooding. Philippine Social Welfare Department admits flooding is hampering efforts to distribute aid. Assistant Secretary Irene Dumlao said some family food packs have yet to be delivered as they wait for floodwaters to subside. Dumlao also vows the agency will deploy additional social workers in affected areas to provide psychosocial support to flood victims.
We were informed by our field office that some portions of Marikina are flooded. And that's the reason why the truck that's supposed to carry the 3,000 family food packs have not yet reached the area. But we are in constant coordination with the Marikina. That's one of the strategies that we are thinking of in coordination, of course, with the local government of Marikina. We just have to ensure, you know, that considering that the rain continues to we have to ensure that we protect also
the Philippine capital region has been placed under a state of calamity. That's as torrential rains brought by now Super Typhoon Karina and a southwest monsoon brought flooding to various parts of the metro. In the city of Manila, at least 8 roads were inundated, rendering them impassable. We're also keeping a close watch on Marikina as the city government orders a forced evacuation of residents in low-lying areas. Now, this came after the water level at the Marikina River breached the highest alarm of 18 meters. So current water level now at 20. Marikina Mayor Marcy Teodoro is calling the situation unprecedented. He says it is now the highest water level they've experienced in 4 years. He also compares the amount of rainfall to the historic Typhoon Ketsana or Ondoy in 2009.
We need to bracing ourselves for the worst to come. This is a new normal. The data that we're recording in terms of rainfall count, in terms of water level, is unprecedented.
Interior Secretary Benner Abalos has ordered Metro Manila mayors to use government trucks to aid in evacuation efforts.
Mamaya, maramihan ang evacuation dito, no? So, magkaroon tayong control center through the MMDA. Yung ibang mga sasakyan ng pulis, ng bumbero, ganun din, iba, bato ko sa kanila. So, kung may kailangan kagad kayo, madali kagad i-dispatch sa mga lugar ninyo as far as transportation, no, are really is really concerned here.
In Quezon City, Metro Manila's biggest city, floodwaters from the continuous rains have affected 80 of its villages. According to Pichi De Leon of the city's National Disaster Risk Management Council, the city government has evacuated over 7,000 families, or over 22,000 people. She admits some residents from flood-prone areas were unable to evacuate as rain suddenly grew stronger since their last monitoring Tuesday night. But De Leon assures residents in need of rescuing, local rescuers have been working since Tuesday night to evacuate stranded residents. She urges those in need of help to post their details on social media or dial the 112 hotline.